Why are you afraid? Is it not that you didn't hear what he said? I remember when we closed the deal on a go on. And as soon as they said, congratulations, the plane is yours, I felt this weight come on me. There are some professions, they don't tell you the whole truth.
Amen. Mm-hmm. Amen.
You know, they may show you, hey, you see, you can get this jet. But they're not telling you that the problem is not getting it. The problem is the maintenance. And the two pilots that have to fly it. And the gas that it takes.
Amen.
Ooh, that weight came on me. And I found myself where these disciples were. And I heard the voice that said to me, has God ever failed you? Amen. Oh, come on. I'm beginning to get happy. Hey, come on, we're 3 years in. Yeah. We bought it cash. Yeah. We paid for that maintenance cash. We've done glory for 3 years. Amen. And we've never come here begging for money or screaming for help. Faith has produced. Hey. I find that he will not call me a fool and slow of heart to believe. You better take the challenge this morning. My faith is up. My faith is intact. Come what may, I'm standing my breath. God will work. Hey. Hallelujah.
Glory. Yeah.
Come on, come on. Let me tell you something. Come on. That's when I learned something I will never lose by the grace of God. It was when God told Jesse the planters the things that he's testifying to now. And Jesse panicked. And he said, Jesse, I didn't ask you to do it. I just asked you to believe me for it. That was my first clue. And then a good one happens to me. And all these big dollars. I did some things before. I used to check the church account and watching all the numbers. I totally disconnected from it. I stopped looking. He didn't tell me to look at the account. He said, looking unto Jesus. My stress level hit the floor. And I started walking on water before I knew it. Hallelujah. Who am I resurrecting this morning? And without knowing how, we paid for that maintenance. And then I heard the voice of Brother Copeland saying, when God blesses you with an airplane, he says, redo the interior. Even stitch your name on the seats. So when you walk in, you know that this is the house faith built. I looked at the seats. They were fine to me. Now, the wood needed some things. There's a place where it was turning a little white, and nobody knew what it was. I said, this is not resurrection. Amen. I said, come on, let's change out the wood. Amen. Are you ready? I said, well, how much is it? That's $150,000. I said, for wood? Don't faint yet. I'm telling you the things you've seen me carry by faith. Amen. I haven't said a word. Amen. And God honored it. Amen. And you are stressing over $50. Amen. Why? Because your eyes are stuck on you.
Yes.
You haven't made the transfer to Jesus.
Yes.
All fools and slow believe. So, Emmanuel called me and said, Apostle, the wood is here. It looks so beautiful. So I jumped in the car and I went to the airport. I said, where's the wood? And they showed me some of the, because they gutted the whole plane. That inspection, the airplane is gutted all the way to the skin, in and out. The landing gear had to be redone. You have to do it every 8 years. So they showed me, I said, that's it? They said, yes. They said, this is what you're telling me is nice? I said, okay. So they said, what do you think? See, that's where people get in trouble. You ask me what I think, but you don't want. They said, so what do you think? I said, this is not resurrection. I said, this is not factory standard. I said, come with me. Let me take you to another Challenger jet so you can see what factory looks like. So do you know? I took them, I showed them what the factory looked like in another whatever. And one guy came to War Daddy. And they told him what I said. He went and looked at it. He said, he's right. I will redo it to show you what he wants.
Amen.
And the man went and took an area that is not visible, the toilet, the restroom door, to show them. And he did it. And when I came and I saw it, I said, that's it.
Amen.
Watch, this is how breakthroughs happen. Looking unto Jesus. You notice, I didn't like it. I said what I said, but I didn't blow up.
Amen.
Emmanuel is my witness. But look, God said, if you take the wrong, I'll move the mountain.
Amen.
Hey, amen. I'll favor you. I'll open doors for you.
Amen.
Do you know that that man did that door, and the moment I said, that's it, that Ricky Ronick paid for it. $150,000,
yeah.
And didn't charge me a dime.
Yeah.
Hey, I know you don't shout when I give my testimony.
Hallelujah! Praise God.
How many of us will he call fools this morning? If he stepped in here, I give you a covenant unknown to man. You would have produced mighty miracles, notable signs and wonders. But your feeling is more important to you. I took the wrong and it produced a $150,000 breakthrough. Resurrection, are you hearing? When are you going to believe the covenants of my God? The covenants of Resurrection House for all nations. Is he going to call you a fool this morning? I told you last night, notable miracles for those who believe and put it in practice. Not those, pastoring themselves and doing their own religion. I say hi and keep going because I know you aren't going to get anywhere. Your degree is not enough. You need grace. It's not my degree, it's carrying me. It's the grace. Even when I feel I can't go on, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He comes on me
hallelujah.
And makes me stand. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
gives me a shout. A miracle starts happening. I told you I came out of the bathroom and the cloud of God's glory had filled the entire place. White cloud sheets billowing. Where do you hear such things in this generation? Amen. These are things you read in the Bible. Amen. That we're experiencing.
Amen. Huh?
You said the cloud of God's glory filled the temple. The priests could not stand to minister.
Amen.
When they were dedicating the temple. Hallelujah. And God came to you and I and said, I had not seen.
Yes.
But the lying demons are saying, well, look at this. Right. Look at that. Yeah. Isn't that what I was doing? I have blessed you. And I kept saying, but where is it? You see that? Where is it? You don't know, you have to believe first.
Amen.
Before you see it.
Amen.
I told you, it was an encounter that helped me come to this statement. I said, wow, God is satisfied with himself.
Amen.
Even if you choose not to praise him, he don't care.
Amen. Amen.
First of all, he has enough people praising him.
Yeah.
If you won't shout, hey, there are enough people in this room.
Amen.
Hey.
Hallelujah.
Yay, yay. Glory to God. Glory to God. Didn't I tell you last week, he said, prepare ye the way of the Lord. Make his path straight. So you are fools. And you are slow to believe. Are you going to end 21 days and remain the same? Are you going to believe every word uttered from this altar?
Yeah.
And put it in your mouth.
Yeah.
And put it in your attitude.
Yeah.
And go out soul hunting.
Yeah.
I'm going to get 20 for him this year.
Yeah.
I won't worry about my bills anymore or any situation.
Yeah.
I'm producing fruit. How can somebody just give you $150,000? Do you know what that rent that is? You give somebody $100, and here you go, making noise. And it's the world to you. $150,000. Paid for it. I need to find out how much he paid, because they went from the wood and read it, all the shades.
Wow.
They were some kind of cloth. They made them pure white leather.
Yeah.
So when you go into a good one, just stand at the door. You see the glory hovering.
Yeah.
Because God loves excellence.
Yeah.
That's what I'm telling you. Wash your car. Keep it clean. Yes, you're broke right now, but wash it.
Yeah.
The glory will come and sit on it. Woo! And when the glory stands dancing on your poverty, woo! Breakthrough. People will be saying, I don't know why I'm doing this. I said, come on, go ahead. I know why. Woo! Is God making you do it?
Amen. Amen.
Yes, I know why you're doing it. You might not know why. But I know why. He said, now, their eyes were held so that they will not know him. Why was their eyes held back? Why wouldn't God allow their spiritual eyes to open? Because of unbelief.
Amen.
You forfeit so much.
Amen.
For not believing.
Amen.
So their eyes were held. And he opened to them the scriptures. They testified later. He said their hearts burned.
Yeah.
You know how it is when the word starts going in there.
Yeah.
The medicine.
Yeah.
to heal the brokenness and the wounded. Some of you don't know what I'm talking about. Yeah? You need to keep reading until it jumps off that page and leaps into your heart. And they love his preaching so much. They say, why don't you come on and spend the night with us? The evening is spent. Or the day is spent. You know, come on in. He said, okay, I'll go in with you. There is this, I don't know what his profession. All I know is that I think he's an astrophysicist or something like that. I see him on television, but he's also a preacher. And then he always has all this, you know, he does a lot of research. And then I heard him say such a dumb thing. And him and his class agreed. He said, how did these two guys know that it was Jesus? They says when he lifted the bread and they saw the nail prints. He said, look. Trying to use the head. No, he said their eyes were opened. It wasn't. You mean that all the time that he was talking to them, they didn't see the nail prints? He didn't tell you they were blind. He said their eyes were withheld. No, in the breaking of bread. That's why he insists that we receive it every Sunday. So it doesn't matter how you have wobbled through the week. You can come that Sunday and renew your covenant. What are you saying to the devil? Yeah, okay, I may have done this or done that. I may have messed up. I may have doubted. But, hey, I've changed my mind. Amen. I am back on the saddle. Hallelujah. I'm renewing my covenant with him. And as soon as I take this bread and drink this wine, my eyes will pop open. I'm going to see that Jesus is alive.
Hallelujah.
Watch. He said, but when they were walking, they were sad. I asked you 2 weeks ago, why were they sad? I keep coming. Unbelief. You're in the midst of your greatest breakthrough. Resurrection wasn't in the process. And they were sad.
Amen.
And they were huddled up in the house. Scared and depressed. Amen. When they should have been out bragging.
Amen.
Amen. When I said, hey, we are buying a jet. And it's like I had announced that I killed somebody. And people got offended and they were saying all kinds of things. And one guy was like, you know, and my wife and I, we don't have much, but we don't flaunt what we have. I said, yeah, you got it right. You don't have much. Keep talking. You will stay there. Because you can never attract what you don't respect. That's a spiritual law. And all of a sudden, it dawned on me. Why will I hang with these turkeys? But the way it came to me was, why am I believing God for great things? And I'm hanging with people believing for light bill. I just told you I received a $150,000 gift. But I was preaching, and I said, you know, I mentioned to you guys that my brother came and took my SUV. I called him mine because he bought it and left it with me. And after 7 years, it ought to be mine. And one day he said he wanted it back. I said, okay, hallelujah. So he took it. And so I said, I first asked the Lord, I said, Lord, I need an SUV. Then I mentioned it. And supernaturally, $70,000 came out.
Amen.
You see, you may be sitting there wondering, where did that come from? It's because you are still tugging. When you obey the Lord and do what he's telling you,
amen,
you will find the rain.
Amen.
It's happening right here in front of you.
Amen.
Watch now. As soon as I said that, the preacher in the front said, wow. much I collect the whole year at my church. I knew I had to change rims.
Amen.
Where I just came from, the guy was preaching. He said, you know, Brother Jesse Duplantis gave me Falcon 5. Hallelujah. A jet. Three-engine jet. He said, so we started our outreaches overseas. Since Brother Jesse blessed us with the jet, he said, you hang around people doling out jets.
Amen.
And I was hanging with people, fighting over chewing gum. Doc said, chewing gum. Bubble gum, huh? Bubble gum. Okay, bubble gum. I had to change rims. Change rims. It's all fools. Why are you slow to believe? Why are you sad when you should be celebrating? Amen. If you believe, you'll be celebrating. Amen. Hallelujah. Are you hanging around turkeys when you're an eagle? How do you know you're an eagle? First of all, you know the promises of God in your life. God has shown you where he's taking you. How do you know you're among turkeys? In your circle of relationships, there's envy, there's strife, there's jealousies. There are all these petty issues. These are turkeys. They're not going anywhere. They don't have a vision of where they're headed. Where they are at this moment is their ultimate destiny. Change rims. Change relationships. I know T.D. Jakes said some years ago, he said, now, if you're the smartest person in your circle, then change circles. When you hang around successful people, it's contagious. It gets on you. Huh? If you hang around where people are doling out jets that cost millions, it hangs on. It rubs off on you. You are not there looking for someone to give you something. You want to connect with that grace. You go out in life and all of a sudden, people want to do things to help you. We don't know why. Because God is making them. Change rims. Move away from strife. The Bible says a servant of the Lord must not strive. It's a divine imperative. The Abrahamic covenant is strife-free. That's why he disconnected from Lot. And Lot made a shipwreck of his life. It never panned out. Had he stayed with Abraham and submitted, his destiny and his story would have been totally different. But no. He said when he looked at the land on that side, going towards Sodom, he said it was like the garden of the Lord. That's what Satan does. He always paints a picture of grandeur, that he will be great. And where God has you seems so difficult and tough. So you bolt out. Before long now, he was in Sodom. Before long, he's lost his children, grandchildren, and everyone. And then his wife, too. He escaped with only $2, who then got him in trouble, and then he fathered the Moabites and the Ammonites, the enemies of God. Look at all the progression into catastrophe and evil because he didn't have the humility to stay with the man with the covenant. That is what has happened to many of you. You left churches for no reason. You've left men anointed of God for your destiny. I know so many people left me and made a shipwreck. And some thought they have succeeded when they chose a lower destiny, not knowing that God was going to take them much higher in life had they had the humility to serve God with me. It's an amazing thing. Change rims. The word of the Lord has come to you. Change rims. Get away from turkeys. Get away from crabs in the basket. Stop pursuing the Lord. Separate yourself from strife. Separate yourself from gossipers. The Bible says that a talebearer is an abomination to the Lord. Get away from this. This is a brand new year. You need to soar. Brand new year. You need to accomplish greater in 2024. God said, go win souls. Bring me souls. And there's nothing you desire I wouldn't give you. And we're believing God. He said, get a minimum of 3. We said, Lord, give us 20. And I'm believing, even though I don't get out much, but when I get out, I'm believing God to connect me, to lead at least 3 people to him this 2024. And he's promised there's nothing I desire he will not grant me. I'm ready to receive. Are you? We're showing you how in Jesus' mighty name. 770-994-3777. If you've been distracted already, if you're caught up with turkeys and in a quagmire and you are in strife and saying who did this and that and the other, wait, there's a message coming you will hear about relationships. Powerful, life-changing. Deliverance is coming soon. Hallelujah. Get it done. This is your year. Supernatural, spiritual breakthroughs and notable miracles. Sow into the voice of resurrection and this blessing will be yours. We're believing God for 1,000 partners. Are you one of them? Then come forth in Jesus' name. Come forth in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you.